So, bees. The problem was first noticed in 2006 when Dave Hackenberry reported to the state Pennsylvania university scientist that his bees were missing. It made the news in April 2007. Since then, other beekeepers have reported that 30 to 90% of their bees are going missing. What do you have to say about this, Connor?
Well, to answer the big question of this world, bees are vital to humanity.
Okay, so what's killing the bees? For one thing, disease. So one thing that disease can do is cause birth defects, like not being able to fly. Another thing it can do is turn larvae into goop. What about you, Connor?
Bees pollinate.
Another thing that's killing the bees is parasites. There's one that's known as Acanthus woody. So they infect the breathing tube of the bee, lay their eggs there, and they will live there their entire lives, sucking fluid out of bees if they don't suffocate them first. The other parasite that's most popular is known as Varroa destructor. They can only reproduce in beehives, which makes it even more difficult than it would already be. So what they do is they have to climb inside the comb right before bees put beeswax over the combs where the larvae are being born. They will then feed off the larvae and not kill them, just get them to the point where they're just strong enough to be able to get out of the beeswax so they can spread the mites everywhere and start the process all over again. And when they're not doing that, they're latching onto adult bees and sucking the fluids out of them and transmitting viruses. So they're literally sucking the life out of them. What about you, Connor?
You know, my grandfather always said, don't harm a bee and a bee won't harm you.
And of course, the best known killer of bees is pesticides. They can harm the bee's nervous system, cause convulsions, paralysis, and death. What else can they do, Connor?
They can sting you.
Another problem is that bees will be able to not remember how to navigate, so they'll get lost from the beehive and die. They'll also forget how to communicate and forage, which means that the beehive won't be able to sustain itself. Right, Connor?
Yeah.
One more thing it does. It will lower a bee's immune system, making them more easily infected by those diseases that I mentioned earlier. And to make things worse, every batch of pollen has at least six different pesticides in it. What are we gonna do, Connor? A less known bee killer is crop monoculture. What they do is use the pesticides in the first place, but also they only plant one crop, which means that the bees aren't getting the nutrients that they need, and the rest of the year, when the crop isn't being harvested, the bees will starve to death because there is nothing to pollinate from. Also, along with that, bees farmers will transport bees all across the country, spreading disease and starving them. What do you got to say about it, honey?
What it really comes down to is honey and flowers.
So, like Connor said, losing bees is very, very bad for us. For one thing, we would lose half of our food because we would lose most of our vegetables, fruits, and nuts. Another problem is we wouldn't have coffee anymore, which bothers a lot of people. Another thing we would lose? Tomatoes. You know what that means? No more pizza! You'll be okay, Connor. Another thing that bees pollinate is cotton, so this awesome shirt would not exist. No more cotton, no more clothes, and the clothes that would exist would be made of less bountiful things. And another thing that happens from losing our food, we would have malnutrition, which means we would be sick and tired all the time. Our wounds would take forever to heal, and we would get sick a lot too. Better believe it. So, we need to help the bees, but what's being done to help the bees? Well, for one thing, some scientists are producing bees that could fight off pesticides. Hooray! Another thing some people are doing, scientists rather, they are freezing bee sperm so they can reproduce bees. TMI. One more thing, a lady named, I can never remember her name, Leanne Newton, created a honeybee conservatory. What's the word, Connor?
What?
What's the word?
Conservatory.
That. But there are things that you can do as well. You can plant flowers and create a garden, but don't use pesticides because you're just going to be killing the bees even more. Another thing you can do is buy locally grown produce.
Hashtag buy local. Take your shot. Take your shot at life.
What he said. Oh. And even if this isn't enough, you can become a beekeeper.
Beekeeper.
To grow those sweet little bees. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed this video. And remember, be good to bees.
I'm in pain.